My name is Michael Anthony Jones, and you're watching Baltimore Basics. And my art, man, it's like I use my imagination. And I think we all do. Imagination creates reality. You know what I mean? This is, I even imagine Tracy bringing me here.
Oh, really?
Inviting me here. Yeah, man, that's just how my art works. That's my thing on art. You know, I said
okay.
Imagination.
So when you mention your imagination, what goes through your mind? Is something stimulating in your mind?
Yeah, it's definitely stimulating, but it's, at the same time, it's like I'm seeing colors and it's like movement. You know what I mean? Yeah, and I know you got the same thing in you too. You got a great imagination. I can
see. Well, I'm not an artist at all.
No, but we all gotta have it. You know, we gotta have it, you know, in order to be here.
Well, for me, art was like buying things that I like. That is how it started for me. Mm-hmm. But for you, you had like a creativity.
Mm-hmm.
I had for me, it was just a hobby, decorating my home, my first home I moved into.
Mm-hmm.
So I like to talk to people like yourself, find out, you know, what is it that you guys do, or girls nowadays, to have your creativity or their creativity within their mind wind up on paper?
Mm-hmm. Listen, when you think about it, the first thing a child does when he picks up a piece of paper, a pencil, is scribbles, or whatever. And that's art, if you think about it.
Correct.
If that's creativity right there. We started as children.
So is it art in the background of your family?
It's in my DNA, I know that.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean? Because it's just, I know for a fact that if I pick up a piece of paper or art in there, and I use torn paper too. I tear paper, like the most easiest way to make art for me.
Okay.
I tear paper, I used to take photos, but now I scribble on paper sometimes and make art.
And that's fascinating.
It's beautiful.
And to elaborate on just a little bit, you used, like you said, the toilet paper. An artist within my collection, who's established, James Denmark, because I like to know the history of the artist and the artist's bios. Mm-hmm. It was fascinating to me that during that era, he didn't have no money, no supplies or anything. So when it rained, he used to paint in the mud. That's where he created his images from.
Wow.
So I was wondering, you know, you have a certain place?
Yeah.
Like, where this creativity is stimulated?
It comes from everywhere. Like, I look around, you can see patterns, shapes, forms everywhere, and I used to take pictures a lot, and I like patterns. I like colors and patterns, and I wish I had some work with me, but I do have it on my phone, but I can show you how the colors coordinate, and some of them don't, you know, but it gives you a feeling.
Oh, yeah, great.
Yeah,
that's great to hear.
And I heard you said it's like therapy, and it's definitely like therapy and meditation.
Okay.
For me, like, it frees me a lot from, like, coming from where I'm from, you know, it's a rough area in Baltimore City.
Okay.
And I see that there's not a lot of people even being creative no more. You know what I mean?
Were you in art school or art classes or something?
Yeah, I took a couple of classes at MICA.
Oh, yeah. That's impressive. Did you graduate?
No, I didn't. I took some. What I did was I was cutting hair in my mom's basement when I was like 19.
Mm-hmm.
And I used the money from there.
Mm-hmm.
To take some photography classes at MICA.
Oh,
and they had like corresponding classes. It wasn't like I ain't getting a scholarship, but I learned how to use a 35 millimeter. You know what I mean? They taught me how to use it.
And that's important that you saw education.
Oh, yeah.
And that helped. That helped a lot.
I had to do it, but I used the money that I was cutting hair with to educate myself. The type of art I do is, it's more abstract than anything. I think people are drawn to me because of just the free flowing of it. I base it on music. I got like a good feeling about music, and it makes the art come out me even more when I listen to music. And the more I feel it, the more people feel it. You know, it's just a natural attraction, I think. You know, and the more I do it, the more I know that we all are connected. You know, it's a basic connection between art, feeling, thoughts, and imagination. You know, that's my whole spiel on art, and I see so much of it going on. But the thing that draws people to it, they love the fact that I'm just doing what I want to do. You know, it's a good feeling too, because I thought it wouldn't be like some people think of it as children's art, but you know, it's really what I feel. You know, it's coming from inside me and outside me. A lot of times from my fears, from my thoughts, you know, I might think about the past. Sometimes I might think about my future. And then I'll try to stay in my nowness. And all that's jumbled up in my head, but I try to, you know, portray that in my artwork. And a lot of times it does get jumbled up, you know, so be it. That's just how it is. That's my spell on my work.
As an art collector, and I've been collecting for the past 20 years, I look for emerging artists or artists that have some type of talent when I'm out there trying to purchase art. But at this point, I look for art that has value to it. And what I mean by value to it, I mean that if you're an emerging artist and I pay $20 for your piece, I see the talent where this young or whomever the person is, creativity will become very valuable one day. So there's a mean for me of the artwork that I purchase. Emerging artists and established artists. And when I'm looking at the art at the present, I'm looking at an art from a different angle where I'm looking at art as a value. And the value is important because, for example, you buy a piece from an artist that's $45, and then a part of the process is having it evaluated, and you come to find out that the value of this artwork is $3,000. That's an actual example. So when I'm out looking for art, I buy it from two standpoints. One, that it appeals to me, and then two, the value. When I'm talking to artists, emerging or established, I ask them about their background. And the first thing I ask them is, how are they documenting their art? Because me, as a collector, throughout this process, I found that documentation is very important. There's a lack of it within the art community. It doesn't matter what cultural background you come from artists to gallery owners to students, they don't have a clue. So as I'm engaging in an image or their creativity, I begin to try to find out from their perspective a little bit about themselves, why they create what they did, and if I can feel the inspiration in it, or if they're just doing it for a hobby. I'm interested in artists that create because of a passion. I don't want artists that just doing it to sell artwork. But you know, if you have this, whatever you create, if it puts food on your table, by means, do it. But for me, as a collector, when I purchase art, and this is from established artists also, the first thing I ask an image is what kind of documentation are you can provide with your receipt or your invoice?